So we can tell that in each scenario, equilibrium price has gone down, even though in one scenario it goes down a lot more than in the other scenarios, but the overall effect is a decrease in the equilibrium price, and the effect on the equilibrium quantity is undetermined, because in this last scenario, where I shifted supply a lot more than the size of shift in demand, I noticed that equilibrium quantity has increased. If you recall, when I shifted supply a lot less somewhere over here, equilibrium quantity had actually decreased in comparison with the original equilibrium quantity. And then in the shortcut scenario, which is that situation where supply actually shifts exactly by the same size in demand, we found out that equilibrium quantity remained the same. So bottom line is this: if you use the shortcut approach, the variable that stays the same in the conclusion section is actually the variable that's undetermined, because depending on the relative size of shift, that equilibrium variable might increase, decrease, or stay the same. In the minivan problem, it is the equilibrium quantity that actually is undetermined. The effect on equilibrium price is determined and clear.